Oh my god. No.
Oh, don't come down here.
Where are they?
Hey, the dog's coming down here, guys.
Hurry.
Come here. Go down the steps right here.
Come on.
Look at the steps.
Oh my gosh.
Doggy. The steps right here.
Humane Society officers escorting the dog out of the zoo and naming him Mighty Joe Young after Hollywood's second most famous gorilla. He's not microchipped, so the Humane Society is hoping his rightful owner will come forward. This dog is a brave one. He entered the wild, ran with the gorillas, and lived to tell the story.
Okay. So this dog ran into the enclosure, got rough talked and run off by a gorilla. It could have been ripped in half. But instead, we're talking about how these are the quotes from those folks. I know we're about almost time, but I have to get to this. I think he was happy to be safe and secure. I think he's too dumb to realize that he was could have been safe and secure if he took off. Also, this dog was a brave one. This dog was not brave. This dog was a dumb one. Also, it's incredibly sweet. He was incredibly sweet. Maybe he is sweet. I'm not going to dispute that one. He's potentially sweet. And then look at this link, Awaz. With this animal control person who wants to adopt a dog that chilled with gorillas at San Diego Zoo Safari Park. I don't want that. Who wants to adopt a dog that as soon as you walk outside, he'll find the nearest danger and effing kill himself? You want to go do it? Go adopt this dog. Don't name him anything. Don't get too attached because he's going to die within 3 to 4 weeks of you owning him. That is Tyler Henderson up in Anchorage, Alaska. He just went out to check the mail, bro. And there's a little bit of snow on the ground. And that big, weird, horse-like creature came charging at him and his dog, Reese, as you heard him screaming, Reese, Reese. She's a little, I guess he or she is a little Dotson. And she wasn't scared. She's going to charge back. Damn it, Reese.
JR, you didn't. I'm a little disappointed that you guys didn't cut any of Reese's press conference where Reese said how embarrassed Henderson made her feel the entire day. So.
I mean, everybody knows how I feel about animals. I love them. But if Reese wants to run out and have a fight with a moose, I'm not going to stand there and hang with Reese. I'm going back inside. If you've ever seen a moose in real life, it's incredibly huge.
And have you seen a moose?
My wife has. I think she has. She's from Canada. But I've seen enough where it's next to a car, and I was like, if I ever actually see one of these things, it's like, no, bro. And it's charging at me. I'm probably moving.
It all started with a family of spelunkers out exploring when they ran into something they weren't expecting. A frightened dog named Abby, deep inside the Tom Moore Cave System in Perry County, Missouri. They didn't have the gear for a rescue, so they took a picture, left a lantern to signal its location, and called for help. The team called the Beale Assistant Fire Chief to help track down Abby's owner. Come to find out, she'd been lost for more than 2 months. Abby's owners say they hadn't seen her since June 9th and assumed she was gone forever. A miracle dog making it through an unlikely trek.
This is a miracle dog, courageous and wise. Right, Waz? Waz is a cat person, you guys.
Listen, man. I understand.
Where's Sniffles? Is Sniffles nearby? What's her name?
Her name's Mimi, but no, she's not. I think she's off somewhere being a crazy cat. But you know, I understand why these stories should be heartwarming. And maybe I'm just a cold-blooded person, but JR, I felt absolutely nothing watching that segment. Nothing. Like, well, these dogs supposed to be so damn smart and great. Oh, the dogs, they're geniuses.
Where's the quote?
So instinctive. How the hell you get lost in a cave? What the hell were you doing down there?